What would you say this trial is showing you about yourself?
Is this therapy now?
It's not therapy. It's science.
This is now my third project in a row, working with Carrie. I love his storytelling, his visions. He's a DP in his own right, being able to execute what he wants.
MANIAC came to me because I've known Carrie Fukunaga for quite a while, and this is the one that timed out the best.
One of the things that makes MANIAC different from other shows I've worked on is being able to start from camera choice and lens choice all the way through to post within the same facility. Light Iron, being owned by Panavision, we get to be involved from the start with the cameras.
I'm not sure I know of any other relationship like this between a camera house like Panavision and a post house like Light Iron. We can always count on Steve as a collaborator who will help us see the project from the beginning to the end in terms of the look.
I like to get involved as early as possible. With this project, I actually got involved while Carrie was choosing camera and lenses, and we created a LUT for the show.
During dailies, Steve helped us create a look, and he would give us feedback on how the dailies were looking and how our exposure was and how was HDR looking for the way we were lighting.
And then their editorial team was actually at the back of the same floor so that we can collaborate from an early stage.
So now we've had a colorist with us from the first day that we started testing to the final color.
Proud of the whole show, to be honest. I mean, I think we got a really unique look, especially, you know, being one of the first shows that used the DXL camera.
We went with the DXL and we went with anamorphic. We carried Panavision C, E, and T anamorphics. I have to tell you, I mean, it was a painterly image that didn't look like anything I had seen before.
I think it looks like more like film than digital by leaps and bounds.
MANIAC has some extreme color, and it also runs a wide gamut of color. So it was very important to create a LUT that served many different purposes.
When people watch this, they'll notice a few different eras that we go through. And there's the futuristic, which is more saturated, more of a surreal feel, heavily pushed colors, a wider gamut of colors within any given frame. And then the vintage stuff, you know, was more constrained color, less saturation overall, blooming highlights. Consistently, we kind of lifted blacks, left it a little milkier to give it a less digital feel.
Of course, we've been mindful of the HDR process. This was something new to most of us. We carried a HDR monitor with us, but once we got to post, Steve had a very interesting process.
Traditionally with Dolby Vision, I'm using my X300 and doing my HDR pass first. And then once we're done, we run an analysis on the timeline. So I did Godless the traditional way with DP Steven Meisler. There was a lot of candles and a lot of practical lamps like that. So I think it was imperative for them to see those lights in HDR. So for that show, I think it worked better working the traditional Dolby Vision way. For this show, we actually did it reversed and did the SDR first and then went back and did the HDR. Once we started getting into HDR projects, we wound up switching my room around. We took my console, moved it to the back of the room, changed the whole front console to make it the client room, and now I'm raised up behind them, almost like a theater type feel.
In talking with Steve, Steve said that he didn't have to do too much work to tweak some of that stuff. He'd say that a lot of it was effortless.
Everyone had the idea eventually that we were going to add grain from the start. For this project in particular, we went with a subtle amount of grain. For the different eras, we actually, you know, changed the grain and the strength. I have a great team that I work with on all of my shows and projects. This is definitely a team effort.
With Panavision and Light Iron connected, camera, lenses, LUTs are going to interface with the entire process of shooting. I'm sure that contributed to helping us get the look so seamlessly.